usual, la-di-da-di-da-di-da. Well, the Julie christened him la-di-da-di-da. His second name they gave his Daddy Dum. And for all his life, and he lived for 90 years, he was known as la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, as he grew up, his la-di-da-di-da grew quicker than his other Daddy Dum. By the time that he was 15, everyone remarked on his great big la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Now he met his girlfriend, la-di-da-di-da. She was pretty, although a little daddy-dum. The reason that he liked her best was she just didn't mind his great big la-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, her mother was awfully lo-di-da-di-da. Her father was completely. They sat down to lunch of salmon and mayonnaise and a bowl of la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, it all went well till the la-di-da-di-da he bent to take a bite of daddy-dum. He count the bowl of salmon and mayonnaise across his la-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, her mother cried loudly, la-di-da-di-da! She said, dear, you should really try and find yourself a boy with a smaller la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, they married in the spring of a la-di-da-di-da. They honeymooned in Trichel-daddy-dum, where they found that they couldn't fit in the double bed for his great big la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. So they decided, la-di-da-di-da, on two single beds for Daddy Dum. They slept in the one bed, but used the other one just to rest as la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Suspected case of Daddy Dum. They wrapped him up in bandages that ended with a bow around his la-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Well, he died on the morning, la-di-da-di-da, a victim of the dreaded Daddy Dum. They shot him in his coffin, but they couldn't shut the lid for his great big la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. So the undertaker, la-di-da-di-da, decided on a plan for daddy-dum. He built another coffin, roughly 3 feet 2 by 1, just to hold his la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Now you read on his tombstone, la-di-da-di-da, the son of la-di-da-di-da-di-dum. Here lies his body, but in the next grave up but one, sing it to me, horse green, lies his life.